And I think it's just a matter of time.
Going straight back this time is Wilson. And he follows with a big left hand. An absolute bomb from Elvis Rodriguez. And this fight is over. Power surge, Elvis, play that music.
But did you see the two punches that were thrown right there? Did you see him step out of range just in half an inch, make those punches miss, and then counter right away, and then place the jab on the head of Wilson and came down with the crushing left hand?
Those are the small things, Tim, that ultimately add up when Rodriguez steps up the competition and he's facing guys that look like him, that have the same amateur pedigree, the same championship ability. Those small nuances right there is what separate guys.
36 golpes de poder, impresionante. Describe cómo fue ese knockout. Impressive the way you were able to land 36 power punches tonight. But walk us through how you set up that knockout.
Bueno, sabíamos que iba a ser una pelea un poco fuerte, ya que fue una pelea que cogimos un peso pactado de 144 libras, donde normalmente yo peleo 140, máximo 141. Y sabíamos que ese era el trabajo que teníamos que hacer, ir trabajando poco a poco, sin desesperarnos. Sabíamos que el knockout iba a llegar en algún momento.
We knew it was going to be a tough fight because I'm a 140-pound fighter, but this fight took place at 144 pounds. So I knew I had to be patient, but I knew that I could set up that knockout. There was a little bit of controversy with the 10-ounce gloves that he wanted. Looks like it really didn't matter. Él luchó para tener esos guantes de 10 onzas, pero a fin de cuentas no valió la pena.
Sí, sí, imagínate, algo que yo lo decidieron así, pelear con guantes de 10 onzas, pero, o sea, fue algo que no me perturbó la mente porque estábamos bien concentrados, sabemos el trabajo que teníamos que hacer y al final, como decimos allá en República Dominicana, lo que igual no es ventaja, iban a pelear los dos con guantes de 10 onzas. Entonces eso no me trabajó la mente, yo estaba concentrado en hacer mi trabajo.
Said, look, I didn't let them get into my head. They might have tried that gamesmanship, but as we say in the Dominican Republic, all things being equal, I'm going to get the win, and that's exactly what I did. I knew I was smarter. I knew I was quicker. I knew I was more powerful, and it was only a matter of time. Sé que Freddie Roach le encanta lo que estás haciendo en términos de prospecto. Dice que eres el futuro de su establo. ¿Qué significa para ti esas palabras? Freddie Roach told us you are the future of his stable there at the Wild Card Gym. When a trainer like that says something like that about you, how do you feel about that?
Bueno, se siente bastante bien, tú sabes, pero a la vez es un compromiso, tú sabes, una persona como lo es Freddy Roach en el boxeo, un salón de la fama, que diga eso de ti, tú sabes, es un compromiso. Sé que debo trabajar fuerte, seguir con el buen trabajo, con la disciplina, con el enfoque, para lograr todo lo que queremos cumplir en el boxeo.
He says, obviously, when someone like Freddie Roach, a Hall of Famer, a legendary trainer, says that about someone like me, wow, it's amazing. It's really incredible. But then it's also bringing some pressure because I've got to perform. But I know that under him, I'm going to continue to develop my skill, my talent, and I'm not going to let anybody down. I just can't wait to see what happens. Éxito en el futuro. Y aquí tienes tu casa. Tercera pared en la burbuja. Three fights in the bubble. This man's owning the place.
Un saludo a mi mamá ahí en casa que está de cumpleaños un rato. Ella quería este regalo de cumpleaños, este nocao, mami. Tú sabes que te amo, allá todo en la casa, mi familia lo amo. Yo estoy haciendo esto aquí por ustedes.
This fight is for his mother. It's her birthday, just like Tim Bradley. Tim, you're not the only one. I'm sure she's not going to have a vegan cake, though. But he says, this is for my mom, and she's going to get a lot of knockouts in the future.
Oh, he is always appreciative of his family and friends back in the Dominican Republic, and he gets such great sparring. He's in with top-level talent there at the Wild Card Gym.